Amazing how we got this far. got here. Got some pictures on my phone, degrees and numbers that I don't know. I address the places, and I have a new old day tonight, and I toast to whatever we want. We're young enough to sing. We'll be right back.
Well, hey, Brooklyn, this is a super chic warehouse. Super chic. You know, we have a play, a proper show in Brooklyn in a long, long time, so it feels... It's amazing to be here. I actually lived in New York when the Strokes blew up. And that was a hot ticket in town, and Brooklyn was like someplace you go to get stabbed. So, or to buy stuff that we won't talk about. So, it feels cool to like be here in this beautiful, civilized room full of beautiful people. So thank you for showing up tonight. You know, we had 7 days to pick from, and we had a band meeting, and we thought, you know what? Monday sounds like a time people want to hang out. Let's do Monday night.
That was actually all. That was serious. Thank you. We have a bunch of stuff to get through tonight. We have a window of time to get through it, so I'm not going to do a ton of talking. But yeah, happy holidays. This is Stop It Sarah.
I think it's sick of us. It's time to make a move. I'm shaking off the rust. Got my heart set on anywhere but here. I'm staring down myself, counting the
stay.
Do you? Do you see?
Excuse me.
วันนี้ที่นั่งอยู่ลุกขึ้นเดินได้
ใช่ใช่ใช่
How are you feeling? Yes. Hi. That was Brent Kutzel on cello and Ashley Clark on violin. This is wild, man. This is like, we've been on tour all year since, you know, pandemic was done or whatever. And this is like a club show, so this is the coolest. This is a lot of fun, and I mean this in all humility. We don't get to play like venues this size anymore, so this feels like, this is like hanging out. This is like a lock-in, like a high school or a weird ass youth group. Young lives, okay, so we've been a band for basically, next month will be 16 years. That's right. It's amazing. It's impressive. And I've been writing songs for this band and with this band for that long amount of time. I've been writing songs for other people and other artists for 20 years now. It's my day job. So tonight we're going to do this whole year. But all these other songs started stacking up. Like, people like songs you know. And I like to hear stuff I know. So that tonight's kind of a sing along. We're gonna do a miniature concert within a concert. Where I'm gonna play real quick in the next, call it 7 plus 3, 10. So probably 10, 12 minutes, let's say. We're gonna try and play like these are songs I wrote for other artists. Some in some cases with other artists. I'm not taking all the credit. And with friends, okay? So it's a bunch of genres. I've been lucky enough to work with everybody from Ozzy Osbourne to Adele, from Paul McCartney to Thomas Rhett, from Ed Sheeran to J-Lo and everyone in between. Swedish House Mafia. Kid Leroy, you name it. So, we're gonna rip through a handful of these real quick. This is fun, this is a medley, okay? That's right. So, if you know any of these, this is the part where you can take. I don't sing these as well as most of the artists that perform these. Notice I said most because there's one or two that maybe I sing a little bit. I'm just kidding. That's gonna be an end, man. So, yeah, whatever you do, just tag me and make the worst comment possible, okay? This first one is by Her Royal Majesty Beyonce Knowles. I wrote this with a buddy of mine named Evan Bogart. Just me and him sitting in a room killing time, and we were basically trying to channel all the love that she had for Jay-Z at the time. And so, Hova, forever. So, in a really, really weird-ass way, this is my love letter to Jay-Z. King of New York, whatever. Let's go.
We're gonna jump over like 15, 16 years here. So we took it, that was like 2010, I'm gonna take it back 2 or 3 years to do the first song. not the first single I had. That was J-Lo. By the way, she's as amazing a person as she is in photos, and she's incredible. Round of applause for J-Lo. Anyway, this is the first song. Everyone, I had a bunch of people tell me at the record label, a different label, this song wasn't any good, wasn't any good. Literally, they were like, you can have it back. You can take it back to a lot.
Take it back. And this was the song.
I don't care what they say, I'm in love with you. They try to pull me away, but they don't know the truth. My heart's crippled by the pain that I keep on going. You cut me open and I.
Jumping back ahead, here's a song I wrote with the guy on the upside down weird looking bass back there called Cello. The artist is named Ellie Goulding. And it goes like this.
Jump ahead. We're skipping a bunch of songs. We have limited time.
It's interesting. I'm going to say this for the record. In 12 to 15 years, I've never seen a venue that literally has a smoking section sign in the back of it. It's like, I can't tell if that's really advanced or really not advanced. I don't know. Some guy's back there right now. What? I don't know, man. This is great. Whatever. Fuck you. Okay, so. Done a lot of songs with this guy. A lot of artists you do a lot of songs with. You do a lot. You only know the songs that connect, the people that come out. What you don't know is we might have done 20 to get that one song, 30 in some cases. If you're Beyonce, 150. If you're Michael Jackson, 200, so on and so forth. So, done a lot of songs with this guy. Thank God this one came out. It goes like this.
We worked on his first album. He put out this song called Old Town Road. That's right, I wrote that. You think I'd still be doing concerts if I wrote that? Just kidding. I did not. But I did work on that album. We did a song. Everyone told me don't work with this guy. Not everybody, but a lot of people. Like, it's a one-hit one. You know, it's a thing. It's too big. Just. And then his first album got nominated for Album of the Year at the Grammys. And what I like about Lil Nas is that dude does not give a damn. He just does what he's gonna do. He does not give a damn. He is who he is, and I love it. And we did this song together with some friends, Omar, Blake, KVZ, and it goes like this. I want someone to love me. One, two, three, cause the dust in the light when it's late at night and it's still speaking to my dream. So I want someone to love.
All right.
So, given that this show is brought to you by Sirius and XM and Pandora, it's like, they're bringing some radio stuff, man. They've been huge supporters of us from day one, so I do want to give a beast. I'm not going to even wait till the end of the concert, which so most people don't want to do. I want to thank SiriusXM and Pandora for playing the shit out of us from day one. Thank you so much. Thank you. It's so hard to... It's so hard to ask. These guys have been big supporters of us from day one, so thank you. Alright, here's the last song before we jump back into the public set.
I don't have a good setup for this. I wrote it with some friends who normally in their day job they do Post Malone on the weekend. And then I drug them into this session on a Thursday, and this is the song that we did, and it sounds nothing like Post Malone. We go together.
This is the first song I knew I wanted to start a band, and I know I didn't want to be a solo artist. And the main reason is it was like 2003, and right when I decided to go into music, I was playing guitar and piano, and just a white dude holding the guitar. And that same year, John Mayer, Justin Timberlake, Ryan Cabrera. Every black dude who thought he could sing picked up a guitar by the end of the day. And I was like, can I dance, Justin? Can I play John? And it's not cool enough. And I'd rather be in a band anyway. So I called Zach, he's right over there. And I said, hey man, when you talk about being a band in high school, not being any younger, let's do it now. He moved out from Chicago, moved to Colorado, and then we ended up in LA and we started the band. And this song was what made me want to start the band because I said, oh, we have a sound now. This doesn't sound like anything else. And here's a true story. It's 30 seconds. I'm about 30 seconds through it, so I got maybe another 20 seconds. And it kind of went like this. I had no idea what I was doing. I just knew I wanted to do something on the piano, and I liked these chords.
Right? And the first time I sat down on the piano to write, and I was writing all the time at that point, but I was like, I need to write something that sounds different. The first thing out of my mouth was, holding on your rope, got me 10 feet off the ground. And I had this next line, I'm hearing what you say, but I just can't make a sound. And I didn't know what holding on your rope got me 10 feet off the ground. What the hell does that mean? Legitimately, I was like, I don't know what it means, but I think it means desperation. And then I remembered, I was like channeling, I was thinking about the two or three girls in high school and college that didn't give me a fair deal. And it didn't work out, and they broke my heart because I took stuff way too serious, way too young. And I thought about it, and these girls called me later, and they literally sent me letters or emails and apologized. I'm not joking. This is a true story now. I've never told this in a concert. In 16 years, I've never told this story. But I figured, you know, tonight seems like the night. We're in Brooklyn. We're in a bespoke warehouse. There's a smoking section in the back. Everybody get out your jewels. Just kidding. Don't do the jewels. I shouldn't kill you. And so I thought about these. I was like, oh yeah, these letters from these girls who were like, I shouldn't have broke up with you. We should probably be together now. And I was like, it's too little too late. And I actually, one girl in particular, I wrote back and I said in the email, it means the world that you sent this apology to me. It means the world, but life has changed. I've moved on, and it's too late to apologize. And so I had this opening line. I'm holding on your rope, got me 10 feet off the ground. Poetic license. I'm hearing what you say, but I just can't make a sound. You tell me that you need me, then you go and cut me down, which was true. You know, and then you say, whatever. So, the chorus, I had no idea what to do. I had no idea what to do, and I was just dicking around, recording it on a tape. And I was like, well, you know, there's some rap record that had come out within a year or two, and it was like, it's too damn late to apologize. And like, that was like the line in it. And I listened to a lot of rap. I was working with a bunch of rappers at the time. So I was like, what if I just said it's too late to apologize? And it literally went from the, which by the way is, imagine a world where we all use the same chords. But it just turned into this trying to figure out what's going on. And then 6 months later, I'm driving around in my car listening to this verse over and over again. Holding on your rope, got me 10 feet. Holding on your rope. I was like, oh my God, I got it. Drove back home. And it turned into, I made this weird, and I was like, oh. It's too late to apologize. And then I said it one more time.
Give me a history lesson.
And then I was like, that's not a chorus.
And then I said it to Timbaland and he goes, God damn, man, that's not gonna smash. 2 years later, 3, 4 years later, I think it was. 4 years later.
It took 4 years. It sat on a burned CDR from Walgreens for 4 years. So the moral of the story is, whatever you want to do, it might not happen when you want it to happen, but just keep pushing forward, because at some point, you're going to go viral on TikTok. All right, I'm gonna do the end of this song because I just bought myself 5 minutes. Here we go. Oh, I'm holding on your rope, got me 10 feet. Thank you.
you take that jump, you don't fear the fall. Open the water rises, you build the wall. When the crowd screams out, screaming your name. I hope if everybody around you choose to stay. So if you have any battle with us on your song and you're not calling me more in the next 5 minutes. No. Kill the lights. Kill those two. Alright. If you have any electricity left in your phones, let's see some stars. Come on now. Lately, I've
I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. Baby, I've been praying hard, said no more counting dollars, you become a star.
Yeah.
Thank you. Y'all know what I think you're gonna like. Can't afford it, it's true. Thank you so much for hanging out with us tonight in Brooklyn. SiriusXM, Pandora, y'all be good to each other. Don't work the rest of the week. We talk to your bosses, y'all good. Just chill.